Dear students, I am Shiva, faculty of physics. I hope you are doing well in your studies with these bricks. In this episode, we are going to continue that previous episode, heat generation in capacitor circuits. So here we can discuss the previous expression with the help of these circuits. In the last episode, we have obtained the expression, that is heat generated in the circuit, which is equal to W plus EI minus EF. Okay, so what is H here? H indicates heat generated in the circuit, W indicates work done by the battery, EI is initial energy of the capacitor before closing the switch, EF is final energy stored in the capacitor after closing the switch. Regarding this equation, we have discussed in detail in the previous video. Now we can try to see the applications of this expression. So consider this circuit. Okay, so previously you are seeing now this capacitor, this is charged. This capacitor having the capacitance C and it is lying at potential V. So previously it is charged, nothing but before closing the switch, the capacitor is charged to the potential V. At that time, what is the charge on the plates of capacitor? So we know the relation, Q is equal to CV. According to this expression, what we can write from here? This is plus CV, okay? This is minus CV. So these two are the charges on the plates of capacitor before closing the switch, okay? Now, what is the total energy stored between the plates of capacitor before closing the switch? This is the charge now. Okay, before closing the switch, this is the charge on the plates of capacitor. Then before closing that switch only, what is the total energy stored between the plates of capacitor? That is half CV square. Half CV square. Okay. Now, after closing the switch, now we are closing the switch. Okay. After closing the switch, there what will happen? After closing the switch, immediately that capacitor attains steady state. Steady state indicates the state in which the capacitor is fully charged and the potential difference across the plates of capacitor is equal to the potential difference across the terminals of the battery. In this situation, even you are seeing the presence of resistance, you can neglect the presence of resistance. But remember, still you have the presence of resistance. This one we clearly mentioned in our previous video. So that's why even you are not seeing any resistor here, still you are seeing the presence of resistor. Due to that resistor only, some heat energy dissipated in the form of H. H indicates heat energy. Okay, now after closing the switch, then what will happen? Potential across the terminals of the battery now becomes potential across the terminals of the capacitor. Now, after closing the switch, potential difference across the plates of capacitor is 2V. Okay, so this plate, now you can observe carefully, this plate is connected to what terminal? Positive terminal. That's why, what is the charge now we can see here? 2CV. Okay, so this plate is connected to the negative terminal. Now what is the charge we can see here? Minus 2CV. Now observe carefully, battery was supplying the charge 2CV to this plate, nothing but battery was removed 2CV amount of charge from this plate and supplied the 2CV amount of charge to this plate. Okay, 2CV amount of charge removed from this plate, battery, and this 2CV amount of charge coming in this pattern, inside the battery is doing some work. After doing some work, this 2 CV charge now added to this plate of capacitor. Okay, now these two are the charges. After closing the switch, these two are the charges before closing the switch. Okay, now after closing the switch, what is the final energy? EF, EF is equal to half into C into 2V whole square. Okay, nothing but, so 2 to 4, so simply it will become 2CV square. So 2CV square indicates the final energy is stored between the plates of capacitor after closing the switch. Now let us try to calculate what is the total amount of energy provided by this battery in order to increase the charge on the plate of this capacitor from -CV to 2CV. Okay, what is the initial charge before closing the switch? -CV, na? Okay, this is -CV. Now, battery was supplied some charge here. So, what is the charge that battery was supplied? Assume that one X. Okay, because of that supply of that charge by the battery, now this charge increases from -CV to +2CV. What we can write? This is +2CV. Now, what is the value of X here? X indicates 2CV plus CV, nothing but 3CV, nothing but here battery done some work in order to remove the amount of charge 3CV from this plate and again supply this 3CV amount of charge only to this plate. 3CV removed. 3CV removed means +2CV -3CV, na? That's why you are seeing -2CV. 3CV added, previously -CV. Now 3CV added, it will become -CV plus 3CV, it will become 2CV. Nothing but through this battery, okay, through this battery, how much amount of charge now flowing here? Through this battery, 3CV amount of charge now flowing from negative terminal to positive terminal. Okay, negative terminal we can assume lying at zero potential. Positive terminal we can assume lying at 2V potential. Still the potential difference what now? 2V only. Okay, so now here, what is the work done by the battery? So work done by the battery, nothing but energy supplied by the battery when the charge 3CV moving from negative terminal to positive terminal. That's why here what we can write, W is equal to delta V into Q. So delta V, Vf minus Vi. This is Vi. This is Vf. Vf minus Vi will become 2V. So 2V into 3CV. 2V into 3CV will become 6CV square. Nothing but total amount of energy supplied by the battery is 6CV square. Okay. Now we will use this expression to calculate the total heat energy generated in the circuit because of the resistance after reaching the steady state. H is equal to W plus EI minus EF. What is W? W is equal to 6CV square plus, what is EI? EI now there you are seeing half CV square, nothing but 0.5CV square. What is EF? EF we are seeing now 2CV square. That's why this is 2CV square. Okay, so here it will become 6CV square minus 2CV square. It will become 4CV square. Okay, so 4CV square plus 0.5CV square. So it will become 4.5CV square joule. Okay. So amount of heat energy generated in the circuit due to the presence of the resistance, how much? 4.5CV square joule. Now we can see one more circuit here again. This is circuit 3. Okay. Still we are using this equation application. So here also we are seeing this capacitor initially charged only. up to what potential? Up to 2V potential. That's why here what is the charge initially that we have? This is plus 2CV. Okay. So again here you are seeing this is negative word, na? This is minus 2CV. Okay. So after closing the switch, but before closing the switch, what is the total energy again here? EI is equal to half into C into 4V square. Nothing but it will become 2CV square. Okay. This is before closing the switch. Total energy stored between the plates of capacitor. This is the charge on the plates of capacitor before closing the switch. Now, after closing the switch, potential difference across the terminals of the battery also will become 6 volt. That's why. What is the final energy stored between the plates of capacitor? Half into C into 6V square. Okay, whole square this one. So it will become half into C into 36V square. Nothing but 18CV square. Okay, this is the total energy stored between the plates of capacitor before closing the switch. This is the total energy stored between the plates of capacitor after closing the switch. Nothing but that capacitor attained what state? Steady state. Okay. Now, after closing the switch, what is the charge on the plates of this capacitor? So, after closing the switch, potential difference across the plates of capacitor is equal to 6 volt. Nothing but this plate is connected to positive terminal. That's why there what we get plus 6CV before closing the switch. This side now connected to the, this plate is connected to the negative terminal. That's why we will get minus 6CV. Okay. So in this situation, what is the charge transferred by the battery from one plate to another plate? Clearly you are observing, na? Before closing the switch, what is the charge? This is plus 2CV. After closing the switch, 6CV. Nothing but battery was taken 4CV amount of charge from this plate and given 4CV amount of charge to this plate. Nothing but through this battery, okay, clearly we are seeing now 4CV amount of charge is flowing from this 0 to 6 volt potential difference. So 4CV amount of charge added here, that's why it was becoming 6CV. 4CV amount of charge is removed from this plate, that's why it was becoming minus 6CV. Okay, now what is the total work done by the battery? Total work done by the battery is equal to, we are using this expression again, delta V into Q. So this expression, now use here, delta V into Q. So what is the change in potential difference? Vi is 0, Vf is 6 volt. So delta V will become 6 volt. What is Q? Q indicates amount of charges flowing through this terminals of the battery. That is 4CV. So it will become 24CV square. 24CV square indicates the total energy provided by the battery to the charge carriers. Out of that 24CV square, some part of the energy clearly stored between the plates of capacitor and remaining energy dissipated in the form of heat. That heat energy only again we can calculate. H is equal to W plus EI minus EF. So what is the value for W here? So W indicates 24CV square plus EI indicates 2CV square minus EF indicates 18CV square. So it will become 24CV square. So minus 16CV square. So nothing but it will become 8CV square. 8CV square joules amount of energy was dissipated in the form of heat energy due to the presence of resistance, what we are not showing here. Why? Since the capacitor reaches what state? Steady state. Okay. Now come to the circuit 4. Okay. In the case of circuit 4 also, initially the capacitor is charged. Okay. Up to what potential? Up to the potential V. That's why, what is the total charge again you are seeing here? This is plus CV, na? This is positive terminal, this is plus CV. Again, at the time only, before closing the switch only, what is the charge on this plate? This is minus CV. Okay. Now, what is the total energy stored between the plates of capacitor? Clearly, you are seeing now this value EI is equal to half CV square. Okay. Now, we are closing the switch. So, here also one little thing now. After closing the switch, there what will happen? After closing the switch, the charge between the plates of capacitor start to change such that the potential difference across the plates of the capacitor is equal to the potential difference across the terminals of the battery. Nothing but immediately it reaches what state? Steady state. Whenever the circuit reaches steady state, at that time the potential difference across the plates of capacitor is equal to the potential difference across the terminals of the battery. At that time we can see some heat energy generated at that time also. So that's why here again what we can write, after closing the switch, potential across the terminals of the capacitor is equal to potential across the terminals of the battery. That's why here, even you are closing the switch, still what is the potential difference across the terminals of the battery? Still V only. That's why what we can write, EF is equal to half CV square. Okay. Now, after closing the switch, what is the potential difference here now? V. This plate is connected to positive terminal. That's why here what we can see, this is plus CV. Okay. Now, this plate is connected to the negative terminal. That's why here again what we can see, minus CV. Now observe carefully. Previously, before closing the switch, minus CV. After closing the switch, plus CV. Suppose assume this battery supplied there X amount of charge. Because of that X amount of charge taken from this plate and given to this plate, the charge here increased from minus CV to plus CV without changing the potential across the terminals of the battery. That's why here again what we can write, before closing the switch, minus CV plus battery given some charge here, say that one X. So because of the charge now, that final charge there becoming what? CV. Okay. So this is CV. So now what is the value for X here? X will become 2CV. Okay. Nothing but here what we can say, this X amount of charge is now going from 0 to V volt potential difference. Now we can say the work done by the battery W is equal to delta V into Q. Okay. So what is delta V here? So initial potential 0, final potential here V, change in the potential will become V. So V into, what is the value of X here? Value of X now 2CV. Here it will become for us 2CV square. Now in order to calculate the heat energy generated, we will use already that known expression. H is equal to W plus EI minus EF. Okay, that is equal to, what is W value? W value here 2CV square plus, what is the EI value? So EI value, EF value both are same. That's why here we are putting it is 0. So finally here we will get is 2CV square. Nothing but after closing the switch, the total amount of heat energy generated in the circuit is 2CV square, okay, joules. Okay, you can observe these circuits carefully. So in this part, we discussed the application of this equation, which is equal to W plus EI minus EF. This equation we are using after reaching the steady state in order to utilize that total amount of the heat energy dissipated. In the circuit 2, we applied that formula. So here also this capacitor in the state of charging, battery in the state of discharging. At that time, the amount of heat generated we found this amount 4.5 CV square. This is one more state where the capacitor still in the state of charging, battery in the state of discharging. At that time now we calculated the total amount of heat energy generated 8 CV square. Again in this circuit, we calculated battery also in the state of discharging only, capacitor in the state of charging only. At that time we found the amount of heat energy generated is 2 CV square. So this is today's session. I hope you understood well. In the next session, we will meet with one more new concept. Thank you for watching.